Hi, welcome to TechGuru.Civil. In this session, we are going to discuss the plain truss problem, problem number 12. Here, we are going to solve this truss by using StatPro Connect Edition. Here, our task is to analyze the given truss in order to determine the support reaction. Then, we need to draw axial force diagram and deflection diagram. Also, we need to determine the member forces and we need to indicate its nature like tension or compression. Finally, we are going to take up the steel quantity. Along with that, we need to cross verify the AND calculation results provided with the STAD analysis results. Note that in the present problem, the units are in kilonewton and meter. Let's move on to the StatPro Connect Edition. To create a new file, click on the new, provide the model information like file name. Since it is a truss problem, I will give it as T space, it is the problem number 12. Then choose the location, then model type analytical unit system metric. Click on the job info, then fill up the job information, then click on create. Now, in order to change space to plane structure, go to the utilities, click on the command file stat editor. In place of the space, type plane, then click save and close it. Now, if you observe the UCS, it is in isometric view. To bring it to the front view, by holding the shift key on your keyboard, right click in your mouse, you will get different view options. Click on the front view. Now, under the geometry tab, go to the input units, go to metric, select meter and kilonewton as the units, click on apply. Now, click on the grid system, click on beam grid. Now, we are going to create our own grid system. For that, go to the create, give the name as anything. I am going to give it as 01. Then plane xy, angle of plane it is yy, it will be 0 degree orientation. Grid horizon it will be 0, 0, 0. Then if we come to the construction lines, with respect to the problem, I need 3 meter spacing in the x direction 4 number of times, then 1 meter spacing in y direction 4 number of times. Once it is done, click OK. Select the created grid system, then draw the beam. By holding the control, you can jump it to the specific node place. Click here, then draw. Again, hold the control button, click. Click here. Then again, hold the control button, click. Click here. Again, hold the control button, click here. Okay. Once it is ready, press escape and click on the geometry tab again. You are going to get the geometry. Then click on the properties, click on section database, go to the Indian section database. In that angle section, select any one of the angle section, then material is steel, click add, close, then select assign to view option, click on assign, click yes. Material is selected, specification, click on the beam, select truss. Why we need this one? Because when a member is provided in StatPro, the StatPro assumes that it is subjected to the shear force and bending moment, but truss members are subjected only to the axial forces. So we need to select the truss, add it, then assign to view, click on assign. Yes, then supports, click on create. Here we need roller and hinged supports, so go to the fixed butt option, To create the roller, accept FY, select all other things, click add. Again, for the edges, click on pinned, click add. Select the roller support, use cursor to assign and click here. Then edged support, click here. Then go to the loading option, load case details, click add. Then give the title as live load or LL. Click add, close. Select the live load case, click on add. Note that in a truss, the load is going to act only at the nodes. So go to the nodal load. Here we have minus 30 in the y direction. So minus 30, click on add. Note here the load is going to add under the live load case. Then again minus 30, then again minus 90, click add, close. Now select the load, use cursor to assign option, click on assign, click, then 90. Once it is done, click on the analysis, click on analysis commands, perform analysis, add, close. Then post analysis commands, define commands, analysis results, add, close. Then click on the run analysis, click save. We got 0 error, 8 warnings and 0 notes. Just click on done. Now we need to design this truss in order to take the steel takeoff. So let's go to the design in the workflow page control. Then here we have on the right hand side, we have three options like select, define and commands. Click on the select parameters. Here all the parameters are selected. We don't need all the parameters, so remove all of them by clicking on the double backward arrow. Then search for FYLD. That is yield strength of the steel, then select it, then click OK. Then click on the define parameters, yield strength of the steel, give it as 25 into 10 to the power of 4 kilonewton per meter square, click add, close. Then click on the commands. Then we need check code, so click add, then member takeoff, click add. Then select, click add, then take off, click add. Now close it. Whenever you get question mark, it is nothing but it is added. We need to assign that to the members. So select check code, use assign to view option, click on assign, yes. Then steel member take off, assign to view, assign, yes. Then select, assign to view, assign, yes. Then steel takeoff, assign to view, assign, yes. Once it is done, we will simply click on the run analysis, save your model, yes. Click on the view output file, maximize the window, then close this pop-up. On the left side content page, you are going to get the results. Double click on the analysis results. Here you are going to get joint displacement, support reactions and member end forces. We can compare the support reaction values with the AND calculation results provided. Here both the results are matching. Then we will go to the steel design. Initially we took some angle section of 20 by 20 by 3. The members are failing and steel takeoff for the initial quantity is 0.403 kilonewton. When the StatPro did the steel design, it is going to take the economical angle section only of different sizes. So for that steel takeoff of different angle section together, we are going to get it as 4.695 kilonewton. Now close this window. Let's go to the post processing mode. Select the load case, click on OK. Now maximize, now turn up the displacement, now click on the view loading diagram. Now in order to scale down the diagram, click on the scale, click on apply immediately. Then we need to decrease this point force, so that increase the scale of the point force. Once it is decreased, then go to the labels, click on load values under loading display options, click on apply, click OK. Now maximize it. Now we need the distance also. For that, go to the utilities, click on the node tools, click on node to node distance, click from one node to the another node in order to get the distance. Now here, once we get our desired dimensions, then zoom it, then right click, click on the take picture, give the ID as LD, then caption will be load diagram, click on OK. Then we will go to the reactions, maximize, then we will go to the annotate option, click on the reactions. Then we need the reactions in global X, global Y and global RZ direction. So remove all other things. Click on the show lines and give a approximate scale of 100. Click on annotate. Once it is done, click close. Okay. Now zoom it in order to fit the diagram into the window. Then right click. Click on the take picture, give the ID as SR, then the caption will be support reaction, then click OK. Now we will go to the beam results, maximize. Note that in case of the continuous beams and the frames, we are going to get SFD and BMD. Since it is a truss, we are going to get only AFD, axial force diagram, that is FX. So turn up the bending moment, click on the FX. Before going into that, we don't want this dimension should be appeared in the diagram. So go to the utilities, click on the node tools and click on the option remove node to node distance. Now go back to the beam results, maximize. Then turn up the bending moment, click on axial force FX. Now click on the annotate option, beam results. Then we need axial force at the ends, click on annotate, close. Now by holding the control button on your keyboard, you can increase or decrease the diagram, but it will not be proper. So in order to get the proper diagram, click on the scale option, then go to the structure, then go to the loads and results. Here we need axial force. It should be indicated in the colors C and D. You can change the color also. Then click on apply, click OK. I will once again show you. If you go to the scale option and under the loads and results, we choose this option. This brown color indicates compression, this blue color, dark blue, indicates tension. So click apply, click OK. Now once it is done, then right click, then click on take picture. We are going to write it as AFD, then caption will be axial force diagram. Then click OK. Once we get this one, then we will go to the reports. Then from the input, from the available option, from the drop down menu, go to the output, search for the reactions, select. Then search for beam end forces, select. Then from the drop down menu, go to the pictures, select all the pictures. Now we need to rearrange these things by using up or down button here. After the job info, I need load diagram, so bring it here. Then after the reaction, I need support reaction graphically, then beam end forces, then AFD. Okay, click OK. Not only this one, we need deflection also. So I will go back to the beam results, maximize, turn up the MZ, click on the displacement. Then by holding the control button, maximize, then zoom your diagram in order to fit it into the window. Then click on annotate, click on beam results, check out the maximum resultant value, click on annotate, close. Then right click, click on take picture, give the ID as EC, then caption will be displacement or in the bracket you can write it as elastic curve. Click on OK. Once it is done, we will go back to the reports. In that, we will go back to the pictures. Here I need EC. So it is in a proper manner now. Click on OK. Click on the next page. Once it is satisfied, go to the setup report. Click on load or save. Click on save as. Then I am going to save it as truss problem, problem number 12, T12. Click OK. OK. Then click on the print. Select PDF printer installed in your computer. Then click OK. Then save your file and choose your location. Click save. Here is your STAT report consisting of job information, then load diagram, then reaction table, then we have support reactions graphically, then beam end forces. Here we are going to get axial force values in each member. Then we have axial force diagram, then displacement, that is nothing but elastic curve. Thanks for watching the video.